Hey all, good evening and welcome to another session with me, Varun, on Tech Tablet. And in this session, we will be discussing about what is Tableau and why is actually Tableau called as an ultimate BI tool? That is, why is Tableau categorized as an ultimate business intelligence tool? So let's go ahead and understand this. And as you all know me, my name is Varun and I have been working as an SAP developer and then moved on into data science. And in this while, I have another channel on Rap wherein I post my Rap videos with the name Hyderabadi Chora or Hi Chora. And currently I work as a data science trainer and as a freelance data science developer. And yeah, this is all about me. So now let's move on to the topic, and the agenda would be to understand or to look or to, you know, to have a brief introduction about data visualization, introduction to Tableau, some very important products of Tableau and pros and cons of Tableau, and finally some applications that are directly used by this mega BI tool that is Tableau. So let's, without wasting time, dive into understanding what is data visualization in the first place. Now, data visualization is basically, you know, checking out some graphs and plots. Now, it could be checking out or it could be developing as well, right? Now here, when we talk about data visualization, it's a process, you know, which states that after your data has been, you know, collected, it is in then processed, that is cleaning, you know, whatever is required to be done, and then it is modeled, and then, guys, it must be visualized for conclusions to be made. Now, these visualizations which we make, they also have answers. For example, you have descriptive analysis and you have inferential analysis, right? Now, in both of these, you know, it could be descriptive or it could be inferential. It is the projection of the same value which you have gotten descriptive. All right. Now, it's a form of visual art that has our attention and keeps us focused. Well, I wouldn't say no to that. And finally, this visualization layer typically sits on top of a data warehouse or data lake and allows the users to discover and explore data in a self-service manner. So what he's trying to talk about is this concept or, you know, this topic, data visualization. It allows the developer or it allows the user to, you know, to typically use other hierarchical levels or other warehouses also, and data could be pulled from there or data could be extracted from there into your Tableau system. Now, this was first introduced by an American interactive data visualization software company way back in 2003, so it's almost reaching two decades in next 2 years. And it was by Christian Chabot, I think, and this was done in California. Christian, I think, was with Pat and Chris as well. And it's a BI tool which helps us in visualizing data or to present the data which is available on your dashboards or in the form of dashboards or in the form of worksheets or reports, or there are a wide range of ways in which Tableau can project data. Now, why do we have to use only Tableau? Tableau is very fast and very easy in the first place. It's got a very highly interactive and a compelling dashboard. It can give you access to multiple databases directly. And finally, it's got Gartner qualifying, and it's also the best BI tool that you have available and stuff like these. Now, when you talk about the products that you have in Tableau, Tableau uses a wide range of products, right from Tableau Desktop to Tableau Online to Tableau Server to Tableau Reader to Tableau Public. Now, when you talk about each of these, you know, Tableau Desktop is something that you could use on your systems even when you have and when you don't have internet. Tableau Online is when you got material or when you got stuff, everything online, it's on the server and you would want to extract something or use something or, you know, change something or visually represent something. That's when you'll be using Tableau Online. Then we have Tableau Server. This is used to feed the data or, you know, to pull in or pull out the data, to edit the data which is already present in the server. All right. Then you have Tableau Reader, which would read different Tableau outputs in PDF format or in a wide variance of formats that you have available across Tableau. And then you have Tableau Public. this is for a wide range of public. I mean, anyone who's got access to the system with the ID and password, they or he would be able to use Tableau Public. The next part is advantages and disadvantages. It's got a great graphic and a visualization capability. It's completely, that's fully integrated support for R and Python. As I said, R and Python are development tools. So anything that you develop on R and Python, you can show that as a prototype demonstration on or using Tableau. Then it's compatible with wide range of platforms like Azure, AWS, that's Amazon, cloud services. You've got Amazon warehouse services. So you've got a wide range of services which you could use this for. Then you can connect to any data repository starting from MS Excel to Hadoop clusters. We all know what big data Hadoop is used for. It's basically used to store piles and piles of information. Notwithstanding this, it's got 100 GB data storage capability, and it offers the facility to create a no-code data query. That is, even a functional consultant or even a person who is not very well versed with coding paradigm, or who's not a developer, or who's not a person from computer science background, would also be able to use this very comfortably. Then you have disadvantages, and some disadvantages are the license is pretty high. When you compare this with other BI tools, you can say that Tableau's licensing is a bit on the expensive side rather than being a bit on the lower end. And then, though it is easy to use, some functionalities would require coding skill or expertise on SQL, right? That is structured query language. So for all those of you who would want to learn Tableau, for example, in the last video, we were talking about SAS. Right. If you want to learn SAS, there is also basics of machine learning that you would be required to know. Just like that, if you want to use Tableau, it's always good to know or good to have knowledge of SQL. This, I am pretty sure, would not go waste or would not go unhandy when you use this. Right. And also, as I said, guys, all those of you who are probably trying to get into IT, Tableau would really be a very, it would actually make great sense for people even of non-technical background to get through to it, because it is all concepts which we have seen in 10th class or probably 10th to 12th. Talking about the framework, it operates, the architectural framework on which Tableau operates. It's categorized into three major segments. The first one being data sources, the second one being Tableau server, and the third one being Tableau desktop and clients. You have everything written on the system here. So these are the three categories on which we use, or these are the three segments into which your Tableau is split into. All right, so you have data sources, you have Tableau server, and then you have your desktop and clients. So it's basically data sources is the place from where your information is actually generated, and then it moves on to the Tableau server, wherein this information is now fed onto the Tableau server, and the information that is generated here or that is fed here is now utilized by people using Tableau desktop or by the end user, which is the client. All right, guys. So I really hope you have had a good understanding about what is Tableau, how and who should be using this, and if it is useful for you or not. Just before I call it an off, I would just want to repeat this point. That is, Tableau can be used, or Tableau is a tool, a very powerful business intelligence tool that can be used by a wide range of people. And the best part is, you do not have to worry about the differences that you might incur on a free platform and on a paid licensing platform. You would see that, definitely, notwithstanding the business requirements, most of the default, that is the free version of Tableau, should more than suit our requirements for us to learn and start working or start flourishing as a Tableau developer. Right, guys? So this is all what I wanted to talk to you about Tableau. And in the upcoming videos, we would also be talking about what is machine learning, what is deep learning, what is the portion of R, what is the portion of Python, then how do we go about it, and what are the different data pre-processing techniques that we have, and what are the libraries required for it. So we will be looking at all of these one by one. And as we keep looking at them in this process, we would also be looking at other concepts on data science, which are very, very important for us. So I really hope you enjoyed watching the video and you've learned something out of it. And if that's the case, then guys, please hit the like button. And if there's any queries that you have, please feel free to ask me in the comment section below. Or you also have my Instagram ID that's mentioned right on the first slide, that would be mentioned almost on every page or on every section. Please feel free to let me know about your queries there. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. This is me, Varun, your trainer, signing off.